Hello, I'm Matt, and welcome to Badger Workshop. So sometimes I actually like to use my laptop on my lap, but it's not that comfortable, and there's nowhere to put your scotch. So I think I need to make something. I've measured my laptop, and it's about 300mm deep, but all I've got is some oak that's rough sawn and 200mm. Now to get some rough measurements off my lap, so I just hop up on the bench, work out how long this shelf's going to need to be and how high up. Then I can start getting the oak marked out. To start with, I'm just going to get it broken down into a more manageable size. So I use my outfeed table as a support, then I can grab the jigsaw and get it cut down. I can then take it to the planer and get a surface and an edge done on both of the pieces. So, as I say, I could use this being 100mm wider. So I set up the fence and I'm going to rip one of these boards down. So I want to be able to join one of the 200mm and 100mm bits together. But first, I'm going to run them all through the thicknesser to bring them down to the same dimensions. The edges are pretty straight off the planer and the table saw, but just to get them even better, I'm going to use the hand plane. I could just glue them up like this, but as I have a biscuit joiner, I'm going to use that. So I just mark out a few spots for biscuits, which you'll see later on was a bit of a mistake. And then I can get the slots cut. I get some glue applied, biscuits put into the slots, boards pushed together and then clamped up and left to dry. When the glue's gone off, I can get those clamps taken off, and then I give everything a rough sand down just to remove any glue squeeze out. To make sure the panel is the same width all the way across, I just run it through the table saw and rip a little strip off. I can now get it divided up into three sections, the top and the two legs. And then I can use the miter gauge to get it cut down on the table saw. So I want to join all these bits together, and what I'd normally use is my box joint jig, and that produces nice fingers like when I made this chest, but I think for this chunkier wood, bigger fingers would be better. So I'm going to try and do it by hand and with the bandsaw. To mark out for the joints, I put one of the boards on and draw a line so the thickness of it is marked out. Now these boards are about 2 centimeters thick, so I'm going to do fingers at 2 centimeter intervals. I just use a ruler and a square to mark these out, and then I want to mark out where the waist goes so I don't make any mistakes. These marks can then be transferred over to the other boards, the lines drawn, but this time marking out the waist in the other squares. So I'm going to start by cutting these out on the bandsaw. I just go basically to my line and down to my baseline. Then I can come in at an angle, remove most of the waste and just nibble away the rest. So, got the first end done, and that's fine.
went to do the next one and I noticed my, let's call it a deliberate mistake. I don't know if you can see the biscuit. So really need to think through biscuit, dominoes, dowel placements before you start. Anyway, we'll call this one a prototype.
Now I want to try a different technique. So instead of using the bandsaw, I'm going to use hand tools. So I get it clamped up in the vise, get a Japanese pull saw. I'll put a link down below to this one and then really repeat the process of cutting down to my baseline. Then I can get a board put against my waistline and clamped down using some hold fasts. I can then take a sharp chisel and start removing most of the waste. When I get close to the baseline, I can get the chisel put up against that board I clamped on and use that as a guide so I can make a 90 degree slice. Now I can have a little test fit. And it's certainly not perfect, but it's not terrible. So now I know it's going to work, I can get it taken apart again. To make this a bit easier to move around, I just want a couple of carry handles either side. So I get them marked out, and then using the pillar drill and a hole saw, I get a hole in either end cut. I can then use the bobbin sander to clean these holes up. To make them look a bit more interesting and a bit more comfortable to use, I want to add a chamfer. So I get my router table set up and then add a little chamfer around both sides of the holes. Now it's time for assembly. So I get some PVA wood glue put into the fingers and spread out. Then I can get them pushed together and bashed down into place. I got some clamps on, trying to pull everything as tight as possible. I checked everything was square and then I could leave it to dry. I'd cut the fingers a little long so I could then use the Clark sander just to give them a sand down until they were flush with the rest of it.
Okay, it's not too bad, but there's definitely a few gaps. So I think we're gonna go with the woodworker's friend, some filler.
So I already had some of this two-part filler in a light oak color, but you could use glue and some sawdust, or even better, just cut nice tight joints to start with. This stuff sets pretty quickly, so when it had cured, I could just give it all the sand down.
Right, so I don't know if you can see, this is a bit lopsided, and believe it or not, that is actually on purpose. Because some of these are hand cut, I thought I wouldn't be able to get the legs exactly the same, so I just left them a bit long and slightly different lengths, and I'm now going to sort that out.
So I can set the fence on the table saw to the height I want the legs to be. Then I can run them through on both sides to make sure they're the same length. To finish, I'm going with tung oil, two coats thinned down, and then one final coat pure tung oil. And that's it all done. A place to put my laptop if I'm sitting on the sofa or in bed.
So this should work great. I'll be able to work in bed or on the sofa. So thank you for watching. Thanks to my patrons, and please subscribe for more videos.